pump. This is the construction of centrifugal pump. This is impeller casing, which has impeller inside. Impeller casing, and this is your inlet pipe, which have foot valve strainer. This is your inlet pipe, and this is your delivery pipe. This is your delivery pipe. So inlet pipe, which is also called a suction pipe, drives water into the casing that starts rotating by the effect of centrifugal force developed by the rotation of the impeller. The water start entering at the center, now flows to the outward of the periphery. And so we'll see how to tabulate the readings, noting down the pressure and vacuum pressure in the meters provided, and time taken for 10 revolutions will be calculated here. Time taken for 10 centimeter rise, and that will convert it in terms of total head in meters. Discharge will be calculated by this formula, that is area of internal collecting tank into rise of liquid, that is 10 centimeter, divided by time of collection. And your output, it is 9.81 into discharge into head. Your input is 3600 into 10 into 0.8 into 0.9 divided by N into T. And so that is how your output and input is being calculated, and efficiency is the ratio between output and input. Now we'll take one set of reading, and by that reading, by adjusting the inlet pressure, we'll go with the different sets of reading. Finally, that will help us to plot, graph, and find the average efficiency of the machine. Now, adjusting the inlet valve and setting up the pressure to 1 kg force per cm², and your vacuum pressure reading will be here around 450 mm Hg, and we'll calculate time taken for 10 revolutions of the energy meter. Tenth revolution. So around 67 seconds are being taken for 10 revolution. Now closing the exit of the collecting tank, we'll calculate 10 centimeter rise from 3 centimeters. And so it is 48 seconds for 10 centimeter rise. Now adjusting this inlet valve, we'll take different set of readings by varying pressure from 0.5 kg per cm²,
to 1 kg per centimeter square, you will obtain different sets of readings.